Welcome to Every Movie I've Ever Seen. Today, the movie that I'm going to be talking about is ATM. This is the horror film starring Josh Peck from Drake and Josh fame. It's about these three people who go to an ATM late at night, and then some guy just kind of stands there and will kill them if they try to leave. So they're just stuck there, and it's cold. And, you know, they're trying to get out without dying. The movie is... it's not great. It's not bad, you know? But it's definitely not good. It's that like weird middle ground of bad movies where you know it's not good. It's definitely not good. But it's not really even, you know, it's not terrible. It's not bad. It's just kind of nothing. In a bad way. You can get movies that are nothing in a okay way, you know, those like middle movies where it's just whatever. But this is a little different in a way that's, you know, hard to explain. But like I said, this is a horror movie. They're trapped in an ATM. A lot of convenient stuff happens for this movie to exist. You know, the guy just needs to use the ATM late at night after their Christmas party or whatever, and his card doesn't work, so the other guy has to follow him in, and then the girl, she gets lonely, so she follows him into the ATM too. And then once they're done getting the money out, you know, they turn around and there's just the dude in a parka stalking outside the ATM, and they're like, "Oh, what's going on? What does this guy want?" I don't remember how they realized he has sinister intentions. I think a guy, like a random security guy, comes up to him and he kills the guy or something. And they're like, "Oh no, this guy wants to kill us. What do we do?" And of course, none of them have their cell phones on them. Or if they have them on them, they're not charged. Because cell phones are never charged or useful in horror movies. And the car is, you know, parked far away, and the parka guy has this like big wire surrounding the place that stops them from running away. And so that's the movie. They're trying to get help. I remember they're trying to see, like, ATMs have cameras. There's like a panic, you know, they're trying to see if there's like a panic button. I think there's like a rumor. They mentioned a rumor where you can, like, enter in your PIN number backwards and it will alert the police, which isn't true. I don't think it's true. I think that's just a myth. But there's a lot of horror movies like this where it's basically just... it's like a subgenre of horror movies almost, which is, like, trapped in A. And you see a lot of those. There's ATM, which is, you know, trapped in an ATM. There was Buried with Ryan Reynolds, which is trapped in a coffin. Which, that was a pretty decent movie. There was, I want to say Wrecked with Adrian Brody, where he's like trapped in a car in the woods. There was Frozen with Sean Ashmore, where he's trapped in a ski lift. Well, him and a couple other people, but he's the only person of note there in that movie. And there's other movies, you know. There's always Trapped in a something. And this was just their attempt to have Trapped in an ATM, which seems odd. Because are there, like, entire buildings, you know, dedicated to ATMs? I believe there were, like, two or three ATMs in the building. But the building itself is just a building that holds ATMs. That seems a strange thing to exist. You'd have to imagine that it would need maintenance and repairs, and I mean, who's responsible for that? It seems like a lot of unnecessary expenses to have a whole, you know, I guess not a whole building, but, you know, a a shelter thing, a building. It's tough to say building because it's not really a building, but you know, some type of enclosure just for ATM, because it'll need to be cleaned. You know, you probably have to do repairs. There'll be damages. You're gonna need security involved, because then you're gonna have, I mean, plus the potential for homeless people to just be chilling in there, living, especially when it gets cold, because you know, wherever this is, probably New York or California would be my guess. I don't know, I've only seen it twice. Wherever this is, it gets cold, you know, maybe New York, because I feel like New York usually gets colder than LA, because when it's California, it's usually LA. I'm sure Northern California does get cold, but New York gets colder than LA. So maybe it is New York. And I know that like office people leaving an office party at like midnight, because that's like a thing that happens. I guess people have late night office parties. I mean, when I'm done with work, I just want to leave, you know. I don't want to stick around work for some party like that I don't care about with people that I don't like seeing but have to see 8 hours a day. That's just me. And they spend the entire movie pointing out how much of an asshole Josh Peck's character basically is. And the main guy doesn't like him. So I wouldn't be in this situation just because I wouldn't be in an office party. But yeah. So, I don't know. It's one of those, you know, trapped in a movie. And I guess I kind of have a soft spot for those trapped in a blank horror movies. Because, you know, I like one setting location movies. I think they survive. I think all of them, I want to say maybe all of them survive the movie. I don't remember exactly. I know the movie ends with like parka guy in his lair, and he's drawing up like blueprints for a supermarket. You know, he's gonna, you know, that's phase two. He's gonna trap a bunch of people in a supermarket. And I always like it when I see that in horror movies or movies in general. When you watch a movie and you think, oh, that's cute, they thought they were gonna make a sequel to this, that's nice. You know, they plan their whole cinematic universe, and then you get Tom Cruise in the desert. And, you know, I guess that's all I've got to say about ATM.